Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Cyberpunk 2077 Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Took the liberty of coming back here to the regional airport. And this is going to be my last quick travel. I prefer driving everywhere, but anyway. We gotta go all the way to Mega Building H8. Boop. The only problem is, is it early morning? Oh, I think she said before 8. Really gotta wait that long? Today, home. Come on, what's the matter? God. Clouds. Body dog. Well, it's made with easy beef. That's horrible. Expect the unexpected. But then it isn't the unexpected anymore. We're gonna have to wait like 24 hours almost. So yeah, meeting Judy. Maybe she'll be waiting up here. It's not too late, right? That terrace? Oh, I'm in a hostile area. Where are you sending me, Judy? Right into a hostile area. Shame on you. My name is spelled D-Z-E-N-G. For, stuff's sake. I'll be honest. I didn't want to write this book, but they paid me, so here it is. Well, actually, it was written by a ghostwriter. Hey, Jake. Just kidding. I haven't lost all my self-respect. Not yet. So, he even reads books nowadays. I thought people only bought them to decorate their apartments. At least, that's what I do. By the way, wouldn't it be better to just get rid of shelves altogether? Something to think about. I might have read this. So where was I? Alright, the publisher told me that they want to publish my autobiography, and do I have any questions? Of course, I asked them if I could swear like a drunken sailor, like the drunken sailor I am, and they said, sure, we'll see. Here's some curse words. Hey, it works. Now that that's over with, let's move on. You might have seen me on TV, where I host a satirical show called Info Flash. It's a pretty sweet gig. That's a female. Info Flash. Unless, well, I'm assuming there's multiple hosts, maybe? Once a week I get to read smarmy jokes off a teleprompter written by our interns, and they pay me more than you make in a year. Isn't capitalism fabulous? Alright, but how did I get here, you ask? Simple. One of my dad's colleagues was a showrunner at N54 News, and suddenly I found myself going around with a coffee pot. Refills, anyone? Question mark, and then period. It was all unpaid, of course. Apart from that, there wasn't much to do, so you could usually find me out back taking one of my 100 or so daily smoke breaks. For some reason, people thought I was funny. Somehow the crap that came out of my mouth made grown man cry with laughter, so they plopped me down in front of a camera, and I just kind of winged it from there. How do you get to where I am? Well, you can't, because your dad doesn't have a showrunner friend at N54, and it's not like they're gonna pluck some rando off the street. Don't you know people like me aren't supposed to rub shoulders with bottom feeders like you? Oh, and did I already mention that capitalism is fabulous? Hmm. Disappointing. What? Is it? Oh, I gotta take the ladder? think I've read that. Dr. Havoc and Radon. They look like a V. Bully? Forever, just get over here. Wait. Well, I can't open that. Oh, wait there. Oh, look at these mannequins. That's creepy. It looks like this one's taking a dump on this one's chest through their legs. Very creative. Alright. I'm gonna wait here for a long time. Sometime later.
Hey,
Judy!
Thanks for showing.
No problem. So it's 5:15 a.m. the next day.
Talking with Maiko is like a game of 3D chess. Don't let her derail you.
Is that the same cigarette I gave you? You got another cigarette. Can you tell me anything more about her?
Some deets about her could be useful. When I talk to her, don't you think? No. Leave the talking to me.
Well, the way I said that was bitchy. How do you aim to bring her around?
How do you aim to get her over to our side? By telling the truth. About Evelyn. What happened and why. Think that'll cut it? No. Have to improvise from there.
Okay. Well, it's stupid to say this now, because she
said... What's up with you?
She said she's going to do the talking, so I'm not going to pick that. Am I here as your hustle?
So, in brief, I'm just here as your hustle, right? Never said that. I just know the woman better.
Oh, that's freaky. Are you nervous?
You seem a bundle of nerves. I've a mind to kill the bastards with my bare hands. So, yeah. You could say I'm a teensy bit nervous.
All right, I'm ready. Let's go.
I'm ready. Let's go. Hold on. I'll open it.
What are you opening? Oh, the door with that? Yeah, they get around their systems.
Lock like that? No way you cracked it open on your first try. Know how to get around their systems? Appears so. Was hoping they hadn't run any updates since I left. Looks like I was right. Easy as paella.
Paella? Awesome. I love me
Follow
some paella.
Me. Judy Alvarez. I'd say it's great to see you, but I've never been one to lie. Also, I never like surprise parties, but you know. Yep, bet I even know why. Thought you'd hit rock bottom when you joined the Mox. Guess you've managed to stoop even lower now. Consorting with a common thug. Yes, V. I mean you.
Hi. Hold on a second. I want to peruse your literature. What was this? An assortment of high-quality makeup products. And I want to check out your computer. I basically want to get into everything right now. So I left a lasting impression.
You have no idea how valuable my time is.
Yeah, me too. Well, I'm glad I left a lasting impression.
Sounds like I left a mark on this place. Good.
If by mark you mean buckets of blood, then yeah, congrats.
Hey, what's a couple buckets of blood between friends? Well, I... Don't mind me. I'm here to blend into the furniture.
Oh, don't mind me.
Just here to blend into the decor.
That's no reason. Why come at all?
To make sure Judy gets what she came for.
Yep.
Jude would have had a better chance without you.
Think so? Well, Judy wants to make you a proposition.
Judy has a proposal about clouds.
Wanna come back? Done. Always valued your skills, you know that. Just don't get why you had to drag this loose end in here.
Loose end?
Stop treating dolls like meat and I'll consider it. But first things first. Clouds needs to be taken from the tiger claws.
Okay, look. It's clear what happened to Ev was traumatic.
Huh? I was convinced you didn't know.
Don't touch her.
That girl was asking for an unhappy ending. I was just surprised it took so long.
We gotta do something!
Damn.
Or everyone'll end up like Evie! Woodman raped her while she was unconscious, then sold her like she was so much scrap.
Yeesh, you've always been unstable.
Oh, I don't like you.
Okay, since you seem more reasonable, care to explain what this is about?
Oh, now I'm more reasonable? Well, give Judy's proposal some thought.
Judy's idea? Think about it. Could work.
Well, well, Jude. See, you found a true and loyal fan.
Something like that. The Cloud's employee took advantage of Evelyn as well. Unless, I mean Woodman.
You aware what Woodman did to Evelyn when
I do
she
mean
was
Woodman.
Desperate for help? You sit by, let that happen?
Well,
Tiger Claw bosses rule this place. Know how much I mean to them? About as much as you two and your problems mean to me. Reed, negligible.
You shouldn't be working here then.
Does it make you wonder why you even work here?
Gonna pretend as if you two weren't ever here. For old time's sake, Judy.
Oh.
Literally moments from now, security's gonna figure out you're here. Got two options. Go out the way you came in, or get thrown out. And that's not a threat or figure of speech. Just a friendly heads up.
Had enough. I'm leaving.
Smart move. And so you don't think I'm brushing you off completely, Forrest will be on the maintenance level in a couple minutes. Alone.
I'm not your enemy here, Maiko.
I'm not your enemy here.
And I didn't ask for your opinion.
That's a fact. Chose the wrong side.
You picked the wrong side, Maiko.
Maiko?
I'll be the judge of that.
Maiko, Maiko. I left. As far as she's concerned. Thanks and sorry. From Maiko Maida to Martha Ortega. Hey Martha, thanks for the date. You're a nice girl and I like you, but it's just not going to happen. What's this? It's like water is falling down her laptop here. Please don't take it personally. It's me. I realize that I'm not ready for a commitment yet. Poor Martha. Welcome to Heart Solutions. Dear Maiko, welcome to the elite service of Heart Solutions. As the sole service provider on the market, we take what we do very seriously. We know that time is money for our clients, which she said before. That's why we guarantee you will find the right person within the next 90 days. Well, she's really looking for somebody, but I guess not Martha. If your future partner does not meet your expectations, we ensure a full refund. In order to help start your journey, we'll send you a questionnaire that will allow our algorithm to choose the best person for your first date. From Judy Alvarez. Oh, from Judy to Maiko. Mina, take your stuff. This is the third time I'm telling you. Take back your precious sweaters. I don't have space for them in the substandard mediocre unit. Lacking that doesn't share square with your ambitions. Might as well just send over one of the bimbos to keep circling you like flies. Otherwise they're going straight to recycling because I can't look at them anymore. It's amazing how crappy your taste was. Clearly I wasn't just a gonk, but blind too. Well, I guess I forgot or didn't realize that's... Maiko is her ex? from Maiko. And I asked you to give me a bit of time to think about things and to give yourself a little time to cool down. I don't care about all that stuff, you can toss it out. But I'd like to come over and talk anyway. This all escalated so quickly. I feel like in a way it was a misunderstanding and maybe we brought up too much too quickly. It doesn't have to end this way, and even if it does, it doesn't have to be so all of a sudden. I wonder how long ago this was sent. From Judy. As far as I'm concerned, we're done talking. I've already buried it, and no way am I digging it back up again. Not with you. You're just doing what you always do, buttering me up with promises you don't actually want to keep. Just tell me when you're coming, and I'll leave a bag with your stuff in front of the door. Don't ring the bell or knock, because I won't answer. Telling you ahead of time, just so we're clear. From Maiko. Okay, and I'll just tell you this. Toss that crap out the window. It's trash. I don't give a crap about any of it, and I'm not coming. From Judy. Nice you can afford to do that. I guess that's what you do with everything. Throw it out like trash. No remorse. No remorse. No regrets. If you find any of my stuff, feel free to hand leave it on Jig Jig Street for the people who need them. Hand leave it? As for your clothes, you could get jumped wearing this, so I'd rather just burn it. You went too far. From Judy to Maiko. You crossed the line today. Since when do I need permission to go into your office? Security contacted you, so don't BS me with procedures. It was your call. From Maiko. Just cool down and stop throwing a fit or you'll get us both in trouble. I have to keep up some semblance of professionalism, which you've clearly never had to deal with. It cost me an arm and a leg, but I managed to elbow my way into a better position. Don't think I can't lose it all just because of a little carelessness. One little slip and they'll toss me into a hole I'll never crawl back out of. From Judy. Now you suddenly care about rules and appearances? Where were those rules when I tweaked the stats on the doll chip so you could jump up the ranks? I didn't just do that for your career. I did it because I wanted things to change. Only change I see is you becoming self-obsessed and lacking any conviction whatsoever. While everything else is just the way it used to be, you seem to be doing A-okay. From Maiko. That's your perspective, but I see what's happening on the ground. Change is happening. I really don't understand why you can't just trust me. It's not like I started out wanting to manage this place. Don't you know I'm doing this for us? I'm thinking about our future. I thought that would be proof enough of my commitment. Looks like for some reason it just pisses you off. Sue me, I guess. So this gotta be going further into the past, and the I miss you is the first one. From Judy. Congrats, Maiko. You've ascended and left me back here in the real world. Seems our perspectives don't align anymore. It's so obvious now that all this ambition you went on and on about was really just you wanting power. Shame on me for not noticing sooner. I didn't think it was possible to hate this city even more, but you went and did it. Got yourself chewed up. I just hope when it finally spits out, there'll be something left of you. The old you. I wonder what these files are, too. I miss you. From Judy to Maiko. Took my work home because that sleazeball was standing over me the whole time watching my hands move. The hell did that beephead think? I'd clep some cables? Anyway, gotta go back still today and set it up on the spot. I'd really just rather you came back home. I miss you. Lesson 3. Yeah, again, guys, I typically don't have a problem cursing, but I say this now and again. If YouTube picks it up, they could age restrict my video or deem it against community standards or something like that. And I don't want to deal with that. From Maiko to Judy. Why don't you swing by the office? I don't have much going on today. Maybe we could think of a way to wind down and reward your hard day's work. Tongue sticky outy smiley face. Your bartender brought me a few bottles of champagne upstairs, and not the crappy kind, from some TC shindig. We could have our own private event, just you and me. From Judy. Why does she come see you so often? She couldn't have just left it. That's a word. Couldn't, duh. Just left it for you? If it was me, I'd have sold it for some extra scratch. After all, tigers don't drink your average piss. Look, I don't know what she wants, but I don't believe in that just being nice BS. Sit that bitch down. She's really starting to piss me off. I'll drop by later. Mox is doing a party. It's May 13th anniversary of Lizzie's death and the gang's creation. It's like our national holiday. Anyway, if tomorrow will be like last time, I just might get over the bitch. Woodman too. I just hope your desk can handle it this time. From Maiko. Okay, I'll be waiting then. I can't focus on work anymore. If the desk falls apart, boo-hoo. I was thinking of getting a bigger one anyway. Why would the desk fall apart? I was thinking of getting a bigger one anyway. Winky smiley face. Just don't forget to come in through the back. Now that they have me to face up to, they'll be looking for any weak points, which of course I don't have, except you. Smiley face. From Judy. Who knows, maybe they'll find something else, like the pad thai you made last week that was too sweet. Tongue sticky outy smiley face. Besides, if I'm your weak point, then you have nothing to worry about, because this solid-ass weak point can take care of herself. I'd sooner worry about all your kinky fetishes and fondness for taking risks. Winky smiley face. And then files. Monthly expenses. Doll equipment, employee equipment, medical expenses, cleaning services, cleaning equipment, alcohol plus catering, unforeseen expenses. We can ask the dolls to clean up after closing, but they'll put up a fight and won't even do it properly. You can let Forrest go. I'll happily take over his responsibilities. Alright, we'll let Forrest go. Run, Forrest, run! J.A., do not delete. Oh, it's a picture of Judy. Well, that's why she touched her face and stuff, and that's why this whole quest is called X Factor. I just don't remember her saying it. Of course, that's just me.
That went smoothly. She totally blew us off.
Yeah. Might just be part of her act.
Don't worry. She put on an act. A few days down the line, she'll call and tell you her plan to take over Clouds. As if it were her idea.
You might be onto something.
Maybe. We're up here next, I assume?
You two have a history?
Way back, yeah. I think I just felt lonely.
Like everyone in Night City.
She was different then.
So was I. Can't trust people that see everything as a numbers game. Line between patting you on the back as their friend and planting a knife in you as their enemy is down to a decimal.
I know. Right there with you, I... Well, used to have a big crush on her. It took me a long time to realize who she really was.
You're gonna be disappointing.
But still, honest or crooked, we need her. Just think, could have gone diving this morning.
A little unwinding, do you good. Do me good too, actually.
Go scuba diving?
I wouldn't have been unwinding. Not exactly. Got an idea buzzing in my head, working it, but can't say if it'll amount to anything.
Was this a different kind of diving?
Yeah. You, a deck chair, and a Mai Tai with cocktail umbrella. Somehow I don't see it.
No. Me and the deck chairs, me mulling over coulda, shoulda, wouldas. Something I avoid right now.
Ah, fuck you!
Hey! I'll kill you. Going now. Back in the elevator. Nope. Okay.
Wait a sec.
Yes.
Okay. What about Woodman?
He's dead.
Welcome to N54. It's time for your local news.
I killed Woodman. What do you want to do?
Well, what do you want to do? I want somebody to unload lead into his face till there is no face.
Somebody.
Fine. Want you to do it.
You sure he'll be there? I killed him.
You sure he's gonna be there? You met Maiko. If that prick still works here, it's because he follows her orders pretty damn precisely.
Alright, so we kill the guy again.
Don't have an ounce of sympathy for that motherfucker. So, we go in there? Damn straight. Let's end him.
We'll take the elevator. Quickest way. Maintenance level.
This thing just goes blop and it's open. So we killed him already. I killed him.
You know what's worse than a corpo? A wannabe corpo bitch.
Hey.
You mean Maiko?
Oh, her. Okay.
Piece of work.
That's
that
fine,
one.
Yeah.
But I'll give her credit. She's dead on about your chances of pulling this off. Me.
Is he alive again? Or are we just gonna get there and be like, there's nobody there because I killed him? Not me. Oh.
You letting women off?
Oh, wait.
Why'd you let him go?
No.
Sometimes I really don't understand you, V.
Oh, I messed that up. Okay. Where was that? Should be fine.
But still, honest or crooked, we need her. Just think, could have gone diving this morning. A little unwinding, do you good?
Oh, she runs.
Too, actually.
Cool.
I wouldn't have been unwinding, not exactly. Got an idea buzzing in my head, working it, but can't say if it'll amount to anything.
I didn't realize she would run.
Yeah, you, a deck chair, and a Mai Tai with a cocktail umbrella. Somehow I don't see it. No. Me in the deck chairs, me mulling over coulda, shoulda, wouldas. Something I avoid. Wait a sec. What about Woodman? Well, what do you want to do? Somebody. Fine.
Show me there.
You sure he's gonna be there?
You met.
We kill him.
Don't have an ounce of So, we go in there? Damn straight.
We'll take the elevator. Maintenance level.
That's when she says it. I wasn't even paying attention to her. I was more distracted by that.
You know what's worse than a corpo? A wannabe corpo bitch.
Yeah.
You mean Maiko?
Piece of work, that one. But I'll give her credit.
Can't skip this.
She's dead on about your chances of pulling this off.
So I wonder if he's gonna be there. Is the guy gonna be there? Am I killing him again? Or am I just gonna walk in and be like, mission, you know, successful, kind of?
Arasab, the finest in personal and commercial.
We've just received word on a breaking story.
I know I killed the guy. Unless there's two Woodmans. Doubt it.
Fuck you doing here?
You're alive.
Where's Maiko? Why'd she fucking call me here?
Evelyn needed help. You raped her.
When Evelyn needed help, you raped her.
Could have also broken her neck. Hung up her head like a chandelier till it started to rot. Instead, I took her to a ripper. Was due a little something in return. She should be grateful. And so should you.
Here's my token of gratitude.
He's dead. Apply the body. Why not? There's a thing right here. Taking out the trash. Well, he was so fun to kill, I killed him twice. I killed him way back. Where'd she go? They just left me? Like, V killed them. I'm out. Oh, she went and she's sitting in there?
Expect the unexpected. Punch the ground floor to get out of this place.
Done.
Almost felt like the world would be a better place once he died.
Maybe I gotta kill him three times for that.
And the feeling, it was so fucking strong.
Revenge is rarely worth it, unfortunately.
You know, revenge isn't ever really worth it. People want to believe it'll be the miracle pill for their grief, but that's not how it works.
There's nothing I can do if you don't tell me.
Guess that's that.
Oh, man. You're screwing with my head.
There's that tone. Yelling comes easy. Taking me out somewhere? That fucking board is on the impossible.
I am not yelling. Said yourself, we got everything here. Tombs, stores, eateries.
You're yelling.
And that's all you ever dreamed of. Okay. Good to know.
I just had to watch that drama unfold. They have the little follow thing off. So now I can't walk slowly behind her. Cigarette? Damn.
Gotta get back to Maiko with something big.
I just wanted...
Appealing to her sense of justice wasn't big enough.
So she was gonna have one.
Maiko only works with specifics.
Thought you might give up after that.
For a minute there, thought you were about to call it quits.
I really did.
B, I go for days tuning virtues in a basement. Know what the chances are of somebody blowing my head off down there?
Minuscule.
Same as Maiko's empathy. Unlike you, I don't put myself out there. But this ain't over. Not yet.
Well, just letting you know, I am also partial to specifics.
You know, I'm also partial to specifics.
Uh-huh. So that's what matters. How many you'll drop. How much ammo you'll use. How many eddies it'll get you.
Not that
art
much.
And dreams of freedom. Can't be everyone's food. Sometimes. You gotta deal with the dirt.
So what now?
So, what now?
Literally what I asked.
Gotta think. We need more bodies, that's for sure. I'm gonna talk to the dolls.
Live ones, I guess you mean.
I'll call you when I've got something.
Okay.
See you later, V. And thanks. No, oh, shit, not good.
No problem. Just, gotta, you know, hang out here. Okay. All right. So believe it or not, we're going to do this next episode. Because this is still not ready. And we literally don't have anything else to do. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.